Okay, this time round I'd like to speak about my childhood hero, who's Stephen Hendry. Not everyone will know Stephen Hendry, but you should. He was snooker's greatest ever player, and probably still is if he kept the hunger that he had when he first set out. I was 5 years old when he won his first world championship in 1990, and the fact that he was Scottish got me involved within the sport to take it up. The fact that then I discovered that it wasn't as easy as he made it look, only added to my fascination with him as he continued to dominate the sport in the 90s. His attacking style, which he brought to the game, which was different to what happened within the 1980s, is now being copied throughout the sport. The fact that you can't be successful without playing that style of play. He had no faults in his game. His long play was great. He was never beaten. He was a great century break builder. He's got more than anyone else within the sport. And other players have tried to take his title as being the greatest, but he has more than more world titles than anyone else has. At seven, two other players have got six, and currently probably the only one who could get to his record would be Ronnie O'Sullivan, has five. Ronnie O'Sullivan himself is seen as, is often termed the most natural gifted player to ever pick up a cue, but the mental side of the game is where he struggles, and that's where Stephen Hendry is always strongest. Stephen Hendry beat him more times than Ronnie O'Sullivan beat Hendry, and he was just a machine. So, and again, his only demise was that the hunger of winning defeated himself. He didn't practice as much as he wanted to when you've won everything in the game. Apart from the world, seven world titles, he won another 11 major titles. When there's only three a year, it was quite a feat. So just to summarise, Stephen Hendry is the greatest, he is Scottish, and he is my hero.